One of the most profound questions that humans have ever asked is, where do I come from? What I'd like to do is take a look at that question from my personal perspective, and you can kind of implant yourself in this, and see how that question ultimately leads us to astronomy. So here's me, Professor Van Heuvel, and when I think about where do I come from, the first thing I think about is my parents, right? For good or for ill, whether I like it or not, my parents is where I came from. And when I go back further, I say, well, where did they come from, right? And I look back and I see my grandparents. So I can see both my mom's parents and my dad's parents. And I can continue this chain backward to try to understand where I come from. And it's something that I do and enjoy doing, but often once we get past our grandparents, it's hard to really do that. Well, I have the luxury of a very complete family history, family tree. And so I've actually taken some interest in this and made a family tree, say, where do I really come from? And this family tree actually goes all the way back to the 1500s. But even then, I reach a limit, right, of understanding where do I really come from. So I might turn my attention, instead of thinking about these individuals, I might turn my attention more to the culture, history of where I come from. So I'm Dutch, and I can think back on Dutch history or whatever I want to think about, trace it back as far as I like. But again, we come to a limit, right? I can keep tracing back Dutch history or European history or whatever cultural history I want to, but as we go back further and further and further, we come to less and less people. We get some sense of that we're all coming from some common core of people, right? So I'm getting there, right, at this issue of where do I come from in a really deep, profound sense. But there's even a limit to how we really understand where people come from, right? I mean, some of the oldest recorded things we have. Here's a piece of the Epic of Gilgamesh. There's a limit to recorded history and to culture. And so we push this back further and say, well, where do I come from? Right? I want to understand this in its most deepest and profound terms. Well, naturally, then we start turning towards sort of biological evolution and saying, well, where did humans come from in their physical sense? Or if we keep tracing back to the very first humans, where did they come from? Ultimately, where this leads to trace further and further back is to essentially single-celled creatures, right, like bacteria. And we get to these questions of, well, where does even an individual cell come from? And where does this organic material, this life material, come from? And ultimately, our best answer to that question is that this life-giving material, this organic material, comes from inorganic materials. Living stuff comes from dead stuff, is essentially the conclusion we come to. So if you want, you could even say the conclusion is that ultimately, where do we come from? We come from the dust of the earth, right? We come from dirt, essentially. Still, this can be less than satisfying. What I'd like to do is take a little bit more personal approach to this. And an approach to saying, well, where do I come from? Let's not think back to my parents. Let's just think about my body, looking at my hands. Where did this stuff that makes up my body come from? Well, that's a little bit easier to trace back. So here's me, and I can think back, well, I used to be like this when I was in middle school. Again, whether I like it or not, that's what I looked like, right? I was smaller. I was younger, all those things, right? And there's new material in my body today that wasn't in my body then, and because I'm bigger, right? And because that changes. And I can trace that back further, right? When I was in elementary school and even younger, right? And this is the same me, it's the same living person where I come from. And so if I think about it in these terms, you know, starting from a baby and growing to what I am today, where did that actual stuff come from of what I am? And this is, you know, ultimately, where does it come from? It comes from the food we eat, right? And we could summarize all the food we eat basically with corn. Corn makes an enormous number of things that we eat, from soda pop to obviously chips and breads and all kinds of things. But so obviously there's more than just corn, but we can summarize it with corn to say we're eating this stuff, which ultimately becomes our body. So where do we come from? Now, so then it leads us, instead of asking, well, where do my grandparents come from? It leads me to asking, well, where does corn come from? Right, to get this sort of chain as back as far as I can. And you know, the shocking thing is ultimately corn again comes from dirt. Yeah, I mean, corn, the seed that's growing, is taking non-living things, right, minerals and you know, water and air, and it's turning it into living material. So we come to the same conclusion if we take this really personal approach to the question. Ultimately, no matter how we approach this question, it comes down to, I come from the dust of the earth, right? I am the dirt of the earth. That's where I come from. Whether I look at that over the, you know, 30 years of my life, or whether I look at that over the, you know, millions of years of evolution. So then it turns us to this profound question of, well, where does the dust of the earth come from, right? Where does the earth itself come from? And this is what leads us immediately to these astronomical questions, saying, well, If I need to understand where I come from, this deep, profound need to understand this question, I need to understand where the Earth comes from and where, in fact, the whole universe comes from. So these are really deep, profound questions, but it's very exciting to me to see how even asking them in a very personal sense, our question of origin, leads us immediately or very quickly to a study of the sky and of astronomy and the whole universe. It's very cool.